Rise on your feet and give Jesus a praise. Come on, give Jesus a praise. Come on, praise him in the atmosphere. Jesus a praise. Hallelujah. Open up your Bibles and let's go to the book of Joel. Joel chapter 2, verse number 30 through 32. Joel chapter 2, verse number 30 through 32. Thank you, Lord God. When you have it, say amen. Thank you, Lord God. Joel 2, 30 through 32, the word of the Lord declares, and it reads as follows, and it says, "And I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the coming of the great and awesome day of the Lord. And it shall come to pass that whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there shall be deliverance, as the Lord has said, among the remnant whom the Lord calls." Father, we thank you for your word today, and that it will not return void, but is prospering even now as you are speaking to us, Lord God. We ask that you would have your way. Father God, release the anointing like never before. Destroy the yokes like never before. Open our understanding like never before. Have thine own way, Father. We thank you, Lord. Lord God, we bind every spirit of darkness that would try to steal this word. And we thank you, Lord, that you are doing great and amazing things among your people. We give you the honor. Have your way. Perform your message today. In Jesus Christ's name, I pray and say thank you, Lord. Amen and amen. Look somebody in the eye and tell them, say, "I'm so glad I'm saved." I'm going to look at another one on the other side and say, "I am glad I am saved." Woo, thank you, Lord. Give God a praise as we have our seats in the presence of the Lord. Amen. I'm glad that I am saved. Thank you, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Amen. As we continue in the book of Joel, God got us journeying through Joel during this 7 days of praise journey. And the Bible tells us, according to Joel, that God sent a plague. God sent an invasion over all Israel. And this invasion that he sent towards them was, he sent locusts towards them to devour all their livelihood, all their vegetation, and all the things that they owned and that they had. And the Bible lets us know, amen, that as God sent this, it caused the people to begin to fear and to tremble. And then the Lord gave a promise to them, telling them that if you would turn to me and repent unto me and return unto me, he says, then I will relent. I will release a blessing behind me. And then he goes on to encourage them and say, "Fear not, O land. Fear not, you beasts of the field." And he encourages them and tells them that I am doing something wonderful in your midst right now. And he prophesies to them and promised that I am going to restore unto you the years. Why? Because you've turned to me and you have returned to me, so I'm going to send restoration your way. I will restore unto you the years that the enemy has stolen from you, that the caterpillar and the palmer worm and the canker worm and the consuming locust, all the great army that I sent among you, he says, I'm going to give it all back to you. Do I got any praisers in this building right now that is thankful that God said restoration is on its way? Somebody shout, restoration is on its way. So he declares, I'm going to restore your years. And I'm thankful right now that God is getting ready to bring some restoration in somebody's life today. But then he goes on and he continues to say, not only am I going to restore your years and begin to restore your land, he says, but I'm going to release an anointing in your atmosphere that you have never experienced before, for I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And he begins to go on saying, sons and daughters are going to prophesy. And he begins to say that you're going to dream again and you're going to prophesy. You're going to have visions again. Touch somebody and tell them, say, your dreams and your visions are coming back. Some of you have gone through so much in your life that you have lost your focus and your dreams and your visions. But God is saying he's restoring your vision today. Hallelujah. He's restoring your dreams today. He's restoring your years today. He's restoring your mind today, giving you a voice that will begin to speak into the atmosphere and shift the atmosphere. I'm restoring the prophetic utterance of my word in your mouth. Touch somebody next to you and say, God is giving you something you've never had before. Upon restoring dreams, visions, the prophetic, upon pouring his spirit upon them, he also goes in verse number 30 and tells them that I'm also going to show wonders in the heavens. Wonders in the heavens. And this wonders that he's talking about, the word wonder means that I'm going to release miraculous signs. Miraculous signs. Now, one of the things I've studied about wonders, signs, wonders, and the miraculous, when God says I'm going to show miraculous signs, for one group, those miraculous signs bring fear. But for the other group, those miraculous signs brings joy. The first group is sinners. People who don't know God, people who don't want God, people who refuse to accept God. Whenever wonders are being performed and signs are being performed, in some cases, it brings fear to those who don't know him. Because in this context of scripture, these wonders is what he's talking about, the different things that shall take place before the Lord comes back during his second coming. So when these things take place, people who don't know God is going to be afraid, because when God comes back, he's coming with a sword of judgment for those who don't know God. But for those who are believers in Christ, these signs and these wonders that take place in the heavens are actually signals for you and I that there is a major move of God that's getting ready to take place in your personal life. For the signs and wonders for you mean, if you are a believer in this house, that something big and something great is getting ready to come forth in your life. I need six people in this church to shout, thank you, God, for what's getting ready to come to pass in my life. Do I got a witness in the church today? This prophecy in Joel is talking about the final judgment of God, when God comes back to take his church and to take us into the heavenly realm. But when he also comes to judge this world and destroy all that is in it because of sin and because of the devil, taking Satan and his demons, casting them into the lake of fire. He said, these are the signs that will show up. And he says, your heavens and the earth, you're going to see things happen. They're going to shake at that time, the Bible says. And then it says they're going to have blood, fire, pillars of smoke, and so many different activities and events will take place during this time. Now, the Bible lets us know that these are all references to what is written in the book of Revelations chapter 8, Revelations chapter 9, and Revelations chapter 6, where it talk about the cosmic disturbances that will actually take place during the time of Christ's return. I'm taking you somewhere this morning. The Bible also lets us know, amen, that Jesus spoke of this final move and this final coming way back in the book of Matthew chapter 24, where he begins to talk about how different activities will take place in the heavens and in the realm. Now, we understand that the context of the scripture is letting us know that there will be many experiences, many events, many things that will take place, many situations that will occur when he's getting ready to come. And in those days is the moment where the church is supposed to get excited. It is not the time to be disappointed. It is not the time to be down. It is not the time to feel upset or offended. This is the moment that you have actually been waiting for. See, my Bible says that when you and I have accepted the Lord Jesus as Lord and as Savior, it teaches that we have been saved. Now watch this, because you have been saved, number one, but then you are being saved, number two, and you shall be saved later, number three. The first salvation is when you accept the Lord in your heart. The second salvation is the process of deliverance that God wants to take you through and I through before he comes to deliver us for the final deliverance, in which God is declaring unto us that before all of these events take place, he's gonna snatch you out of some things you've never been in. You better come on in here or come out of before. Touch two or three people in here and say, neighbor, before God come back to take the church, he gonna snatch you out of some stuff and place you in some things you ain't never been in before. Do I got at least five praises in here? I'm already ready to preach. I'm already ready to go forth. Somebody shout, my delivery date has come. Do I got somebody that got a praise? Render it to God right now. He said, these things will take place, pillars of smoke. He goes on, keep going, talking about how the sun is going to be turned to darkness and the moon into blood before the great day, or before the coming of the great and awesome day of the Lord. And so what God is saying is there are going to be some serious things that happen before the final coming of Jesus Christ. And these things are signs of your breakthrough. So look somebody in the eyes and say, everything you've going through is an indication that something big is getting ready to come forth for you. It is a sign to show you that there is something miraculous that the Father God is getting ready to do. I don't know what you've been dealing with, but I dare you to get ready and praise him right now where you are, because the Bible says that it shall come to pass. I need somebody in the church that will begin to tell God thank you for what's getting ready to come to pass. Before he rapture his church, he's gonna take you somewhere in his glory you ain't never been in before. It shall come to pass. Do I got anybody that believe it? Somebody lift your voice and shout, Lord, I believe it. That something is getting ready to happen supernaturally in my life. There's something miraculous going to take place in my life. So he says, it shall come to pass. What shall come to pass? That whoever calls on the name of 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 the name. Look at your neighbor and ask them the question, do you know his name? Because in this season, before he takes the church, it is vital that you know his name. It is very important and imperative to your life that you know his name. And when you utter and open up your mouth and declare and decree his name, my Bible says, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ, he is Lord. And so he's declaring unto us that I'm coming quickly. I'm getting ready to come and part the skies, and I'm going to eventually take you all back to the heavens with me. But before I come and get you, you better declare and use my name as you go through your seasons. I need a praiser that know how to shout his name. Shout his name right now. Whoever calls on the name of the Lord Jesus. When you can't call on nobody else, you better learn to call on him. See, we are in salvation transition. We're born again, but we're still going through a process until he come and take us back to the heavens. So it's that process that we're in. And it's when you're in the middle of your process, when you're in the deliverance process, that you got to learn to call on Jesus. When you're going through warfare, call on Jesus. When you ain't got things all together, call on Jesus. And he says, in the midst of it all, those that know how to open their mouth and call on the name of the Lord, he said, there shall be saved. Do I got at least one worshiper in this church today that want to see God bring you some deliverances into your house? Somebody just begin to lift up holy hands and say, Lord, I need you to bring me through. Bring me through. Bring me out. Bring me up. Take me to that next place. Somebody shout, this is my delivery stage. I'm in the process of a major move of God, a major breakthrough from God, a major transition. There is a transaction that has taken place from the super into my natural realm, and I'm pulling down. And so until he comes, I'm gonna shout his name. Until he comes, I'm gonna walk by faith. Until he comes, I'm gonna speak his word. Until he comes, I'm gonna keep my dance. I'm gonna preach that gospel until he comes. No matter what I go through, I believe my Redeemer lives. Do I got a praiser that will shout his praise? Those who call on the name. Woo! Of the Lord, they will be saved. Saved meaning healed. Saved meaning rescued from danger. Saved mean delivered from the evil one. Saved mean pulled out of the pit, snatched out of the mire. Y'all don't hear me up in this church. Saved mean to be hailed and kept from falling and declared faultless. Saved mean I'm not only going to give you a born again experience, but I'm going to transform you by the renewing of your mind, which means saved also mean I'm going to give you your sanity back. I'm going to give you your joy back. I'm going to give you your peace back. Saved. Do I got somebody to believe that this is the season of your deliverance? Somebody shout, I'm in the process of a major breakthrough. And I'm so glad I'm saved, because if I'm saved, he'll pull me out. If I'm saved, he'll snatch me up. Somebody shout, I'm glad that I'm saved. They that call the name of the Lord shall be saved, healed, delivered. Another root word for salvation or saved means rescued from danger, but it means restored. Look somebody in the eye and prophesy and say, God said that before you go home to glory, you're going to experience some serious restoration. He restoreth my soul. My cup runneth over. Do I got anybody to believe that God said, I'm going to restore? See, he said, you're going to deal with some things that will come, but I will be there to snatch you out every time. No matter if you in the fiery furnace or in the midst of the lion's den, he says, I will deliver you. He says in the text, for in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem. See, Jerusalem represents a state or a position of peace, not only a location called Shalom home or a location of Jerusalem, as in the city of David, but it is also a signal or a sign of God's peace. And so what is he saying? He said, tell my people that the deliverance that I'm sending their way is going to bring peace like never before, restoration in your mind and heart like never before. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem, he says what? There shall be deliverance. Call Mount Zion yourself, call Jerusalem your family, and prophesy and say, they shall be delivered. I shall be delivered. I am free. I am healed. I am blessed. Do I got somebody that believe that the deliverer is in the atmosphere? Shake this room with a praise. Give God a praise quake in the atmosphere and believe that this is the season for your deliverance. Before God takes us to rapture us as a church into heaven, he has to first deliver us in here. He wants us to experience the rapture within, where he has caused you to be caught up. Slap 2 or 3, high five, and say, I'm going to get caught up in my mind. Which means my mind is getting ready to grow afar and beyond all of this stuff that's going. See, a real deliverance means that you have grown and have been exalted higher than the storm. It don't mean that storm stop. It means I've become able to walk out of and overtake and walk through. You don't hear me. See, when God said, I've delivered you, that means you can still be in the midst of hate and be all right. And it don't even hurt you anymore. Do I got somebody to believe that this is your delivery date? Somebody shout amen. Say, there shall be deliverance. Shall be meaning there is no reversing it. It is an order. It is a decree. It is written. When God say it shall happen, nobody can erase. Nobody can try to talk God out of doing. See, aren't you glad that when God say this is your season, can't no devil stop it? Aren't you glad that when God said, I have sealed you for the day of redemption, can't nobody unseal you? Aren't you glad that when God says, I have decreed a thing concerning you and that I'm going to make a way concerning you, it don't matter how many floods come, it don't matter how many imps rise, it don't matter how many devils try to speak against it, it don't matter how many folks try to persecute you, it don't matter what weapon is formed against you, my Bible says that it will not prosper nor will it work. I need 6 praisers that know that when God speaks a thing, it will come to pass, and it shall come to pass. That what? There shall be deliverance. But this deliverance, as the Lord said, it's going to take place as the Lord, the God of creation, the master ruler, and the owner of all things. It will happen as the Lord has said. But here's key: among the remnant, the deliverance is for the remnant. For the word remnant means those who remain. Word remnant means the residue. Word remnant also means those who have survived. Look somebody in the eye and say, neighbor, I am a survivor. You don't know what I had to survive to be in this building. Y'all, come on, y'all. Oh my God, help me, Lord. You don't know how many afflictions that I had to survive. You don't know how many things have been spoken about you and spoken against you and spoken concerning you, folks. You don't hear what I'm saying. Touch my, if I told you what I had to come through, you will jump with a shout with me. You wouldn't be looking at me funny. You'll be praising the Lord on my behalf. Matter of fact, you'll be shouting so loud because you understand that what I came through is nothing compared to what you came through, and you'll start shouting with me. You'll bless the Lord in the building. I am a remnant. I'm a survivor, and because I have survived and I have made it through the grace of God, God said there's something big coming your way. For matter of fact, for every person in here, God has already declared the decree today. He said, this is my declaration of the day, that everybody that endured and everybody who survived, he says, over the next 30 days, he said, you're going to see a major deliverance, a major breaking out, and a major breaking through. Come on, I believe God. Do you believe God in this room right now? Somebody shout hallelujah. I'm talking to the people who almost quit but didn't. I'm talking to the people who almost fainted but didn't. I'm talking to the people who almost said forget everything and everybody, but instead you decided that you're going to give it one more try. Well, guess what, honey? God's got a blessing with your name on it, and he is the rescuer, the healer, the deliverer, and the rewarder of those who diligently seek him. He says for those who are the remnant, the survivors, he said, what? I'm going to bring major salvation, major breakthrough, and major moves for their lives. Do I got any survivors up in here? Those who are the remnant, those who remain after all of the stuff that goes on around. See, here's the true fact, that everybody don't survive during the shaking. See, when God sends a correction in the land, everybody don't make it. There's one verse that say, if you can survive the sword. He said it in Jeremiah, if you can handle surviving the sword. Oh, y'all don't hear me. He said, then I can bless you. See, it's the ones that, what do you mean survive? After all of the stuff that goes on, if you still got a praise on you. If you have turned to God with a heart of repentance and you still got a worship in your belly, after I done been rebuked, after I done been checked, after I done been corrected, and after I done went through everything the devil can throw my way, if I'm still a worshiper, if you can survive the sword, I can bless you where you are. Somebody shout hallelujah. Everybody can't take it. Everybody can't take the shaking. Everybody can't take the suffering. See, that sword also represents suffering for him. See, we all want to reign in victory. But in order to reign in victory, you got to be able to endure the affliction. Some of us have endured some major. Whew. See, every affliction is not the same. So we can never say that my affliction is better or greater or less important than yours. Because your affliction might be a physical affliction, but somebody else's, it was a mental affliction. Somebody in here endured a fight in your head. I preach to the drums then. I preach to the piano. Come on. I said somebody in here dealt with a fight in your brain.
Your mind was everywhere. You smiled on the outside, but on the inside, your thoughts was running so rapid that it was hard for you to sleep. You were having nightmares and was saying, I don't know what's going on. But the reason why is because you have dealt with a sword of affliction that God permitted. And God said, if you endured that sword, my God, he said, I'm going to pull you and snatch you and deliver you and pull you out of every affliction. Some people can't take it, but I'm here to tell you, if you can take it, you can make it. And if you can make it, God's going to get the glory out of your life. Do I got anybody?
I dealt with the physical, the mental, the emotional. That emotional was huge. Sad, worried, anxious, afraid. Am I calling anybody's number? Disappointed, let down. As it say in the scripture, unrelenting disappointments. I mean, just back-to-back stuff. Feeling great, boom, hit with another one. Made it through that, bam, hit with another one. And after a while, you get hit so many times, you start walking around feeling like, oh my goodness, I don't know if I could take one more blow. But God, y'all better come on up in here. Touch your neighbor and say, God kept you while you were going through your stuff. God kept preserved you while you were dealing with your stuff. I can hear him saying audibly in my spirit saying, don't quit. You're almost there. You're almost there. You are at the crossing period. You're at the finish line. Don't you quit, because he already told you, by his stripes you are healed. Come on, we're gonna walk this healing out. Come on, we're gonna walk this healing out, Lee Johnson. We're gonna walk this healing out. Grobosha, I need everybody to start praying for him right now. God told me to hold your hand and to release virtue into your spirit from the Holy Ghost while we're praying. Come on, I need everybody on your feet praying. There's a turning in the Holy Ghost right now. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Because God said cancer can't have body, sickness can't have this body, infirmity can't have this body. Come on, I need somebody that can worship. God said, I'm building your strength, I'm building your faith, I'm building your mind so that you can stand. He said, you will endure this hardship, you will endure this war, you will make it. Come on, I need a real praise that will worship with him. Go ahead, Lee, and give God his praise. Go ahead, Lee. Give God his worship. Go ahead. Y'all better rejoice with the man of God. Somebody rejoice with him. Rejoice with him. You just ran into your healing. Take another lap, Johnson. God is doing a new thing. Come on and lift him high. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. If you can endure, you will be blessed. Salvation, deliverance, healing, restoration has come. I need somebody else in the building that believe God to thank him. Yeah. 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 Do I got anybody that got some worship in your belly that believe God for divine impartation? Divine impartation. It comes through your worship. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Come on, come on, come on. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it.
Worship. 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 There's an anointing flowing in this room. I dare you to get in and tap in. God told us this morning that he has released the anointing. There's a river that's flowing from the altar. A river is flowing from the altar. A river is flowing from the altar, and it is flushing, and it is gushing, and it is flowing into the atmosphere. And if you would just get in, like the man that was sitting by the sea, he said, I don't got nobody to put me in. And Jesus said, don't worry about anybody putting you in. I'm calling you to be made well. Come forward and be made well. Be whole. Be whole. There's healing in the room right now.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. Healing waters, healing waters, healing waters, healing waters, healing waters, healing waters. Short of the Bosi, healing waters, healing waters. That's it, mama. Cry out to him. Healing waters, healing waters, healing waters. Ooh, glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. He said, healing waters. That's it. Shh. Yeah, 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 daughter. God said, this is your restoration moment. This is your season of breakthrough. This is your, he said, this is your moment to come back. This is a comeback for you. This is a comeback. As if you've been so far away and felt so far away. But God said, you coming back. He said, I'm bringing you back stronger than ever. Oh, God. And he says, this thing in this season is going to be so real to you. So real, so tangible to you. God said, I'm going to show you who I am. And I'm going to reveal to you the secrets of the kingdom. I'm going to open up the eyes of your understanding that you may see the glory of God. No more will the enemy hold you down. No more will he break you down. No more will the strong man break you. God said to tell you, this is your breakthrough moment. Somebody better praise with her. Break. 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 Break, God. Do it, God. Do it, God. Ah! Somebody praise him. Come on. Talk to the Father. Talk to the Father. He's moving. He's moving. He's moving. He's moving. Keep that worship high. Keep that praise alive. Yes, God. Yes, God. Consuming fire. Oh, no, 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 we'll see. Oh, God. This is the altar call. We're not going to do a normal altar call. There's healing at the altar. He's moving in the room. I'm encouraging you to grab. Get it. Get it. You want your sight? Praise him. You want your breakthrough? Praise him. You need your home? Praise him. You need a door open? Praise him. You want your marriage back? Praise him. You want God to send you the right man or woman? Worship him. He's doing it now. He said, your whole household is going to come back to the power of God like never before. Yeah, yeah, yeah. He says that he's going to open financial doors for your family. And he says, don't worry, because these transitions you've gone through are all setups to be blessed up. He said, you've been set up to be blessed up in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And you're going to come forth and say, let me testify on how the Lord brought me out, brought me through, and delivered my family, delivered me, made a way in my wilderness, made manna come from heaven, caused water to come out of rocks for me. God's going to show you miraculous signs and wonders. Come on, I need to praise it up and worship with it right now. There's an anointing flowing at the altar.
There's an anointing, rivers of living water. Flow, flow, God, flow. Come on, call on him. Call on him. Call on him. Come on, call on the name. Call on the name. Call on the name. Call on the name. We want the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. We need the fire of the
Come on,
Spirit.
Let the sound of worship be
released. Yeah. Ooh, glory. Ooh, glory. Glory. Glory.
Ooh, that's good. Y'all raise it.
Bring it down just a little bit. Because you've opened your doors to show love in this season. He says, I'm going to open for you three doors just for you in this season. Three doors shall open. Three doors. He says, matter of fact, I'm giving you the keys to the kingdom. And what you bind shall be bound. And what you loose shall be loose. God said, heaven is backing you. He said, heaven is backing you. In the name of Jesus. Ooh, glory to God. And he says, you open doors for other families. He says, so I'm going to open up a way for your family. Those you've interceded for in your own family. You became family to the family less. And he says, I'm going to restore even your personal family because of what you become for my people. Oh, God, I need a real worshiper that will stand in the gap. Stand in the gap. Come on. Ask him to fill you up. Say, fill me up, God. The Spirit of God. Fill me up.
Fill me up.
Fill me up.
Fill me up.
The hand of the Lord God rest upon you. Rest upon you. Rest upon you. I see in the Spirit, when you came in this place, God set my eyes right to you. And he showed me that you've been dealing with a lot of things that have hurt you, vexed you, made you a little irritated and upset. And God said to encourage you, daughter, to let you know that the cloud has been lifted. The cloud of anger, the cloud of stress, the cloud of worry. I can even see a huge question mark sitting on top of your head, questioning, what's next? When? Why is this happening? Where is it going to come from? When are you going to do it? And the Lord said, right now. Now is the time. Now is the time. Now is the time. I need somebody that will bless God with her to praise. Praise him. Praise him. I will open up. Fill me up. Fill me. Fill me up. Fill me. Fill me up. Feel me. Father, I speak to his joints. I speak to his knees. I speak to his body. And I declare right now, I declare that you have come to bring healing and deliverance to this body because he's your servant who have served you with gladness, who have honored you, who have worshiped you, who have obeyed you in his seasons, who've done what thus says the Lord despite of what he's been through. And I declare, Father God, oh God, God said to tell you that he's reactivating your mouth. He says, because you're a prophet of the Lord, you have a prophetic voice. And he says he's restirring and reactivating your mouth. And he says, I want you to begin to speak again and declare again the things that I show you and reveal to you. He says, this is the season to begin to carry out your mantle. This is the season to speak on behalf of the heavens. I declare right now, I declare that this mouth, Father God, shall speak the oracles of God. I declare that this house is blessed. This house is healed. This house is sound. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, every attack that has come against this body, we send back to the pit where it belongs. Every negative report that has come, every fearful thought that has tried to rise up, we chase out now Lord, you sent your word to deliver us. And we thank you for healing right now. Lord, I speak healing in her body, healing in her soul, healing in her heart. God said, oh, go, shata. He cannot, he said some of the physical things had to do with the emotional things. He said, daughter, you have been so hurt over the years that it's tried to manifest in your natural. But he said, I have sent my word even into the deep parts of your inner person and have healed you from every broken area. And he said, I'm taking the broken pieces, every broken piece, everything that came against you that tried to shatter you. He said, the devil is a liar. I'm restoring you. I'm rejuvenating you, reviving you, renewing your mind and your heart. Somebody got to praise worship with her right now. Fill me up. Till I open, I want to go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So many let you down, have taken advantage of you. You help all kind of folks, taking care of their children, blessing folks, helping, encouraging them, cooking for folks. You've done a whole lot, and nobody seemed to pay attention to when you go through. But the Lord said he stopped by to pay attention. He said, I'm stopping by to say thank you for your good and faithful service that you've rendered for my namesake, says the Lord. You've done for me, says the Lord. You served, says the Lord. You've been obedient, says the Lord. And God said, receive, receive and be healed. Receive and be restored. Receive and be encouraged, says the Lord. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You carried your daughters and you carried your grandchildren and you and he said, I'm gonna grab your grandson and snatch him into his purpose. Grab him and snatch him in. I'ma snatch him in. I'ma snatch. He's a preacher. He said, I'ma snatch him. I'ma snatch him. I'ma grab him. He will not be destroyed by the devil. Come on, I need a real worshiper. Till I overflow. Yeah. 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 Come on, worship him. Till I overflow. Fire of the Lord. Fire of the Lord. Bring it down a little bit. See, people look at you but don't see the real you. They don't see the genuine, compassionate, loving person that you are. You have a heart. God said, you got a big heart too. And you care about stuff that other folks feel like you shouldn't even be thinking about. Why are you caring about that kind of stuff? You have a desire to see things happen for people. You know why you have that heart, Dave? Because God has given you the right name. Dave. For the name Dave or David means to be loved and to love. God has given you love in your heart. And he says, I have beloved you. Which means God said, I set my love on you and I've set my love within you. And he says, my love is going to flow through you. And it's going to touch those who come around you, family, friends, loved ones, and even folks you have never met. You will stop to help folks that don't. Nobody else would even look at them. He said, because I've given you the heart of David. You are a warrior in God, a worshiper in God. You are a man of God. And God said, in this season, watch what he does for you. Watch what he does. Come on. I need somebody that would bless God with him. Bless God with him. Come on. Come on. He said, I moved you all this way to move you into something good, something new. He says, I'm transitioning you into a place in God, says the Lord. He said, oh, my. It's this transition that you've just gone through that's getting ready to set you up now for the major blessings of God.
Major blessings of God. Major blessings. Which means there's so many things that God's going to just open up for you. Mm-hmm. He said, I had to move you out of the places that you were in. And I had to place you under the care of your family. He said, because they are going to release some things into your spirit. He says, they're releasing. They're making deposits in you. It's a preparation. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. And he said to tell you, he's healing you from all the hurts, even in the relationships hurts that you've experienced. You've been broken in those areas, disappointed. You struggled in those areas, had to fight and had to endure some areas. But the Lord said, receive your breakthrough, your restoration. This is the season where you become the butterfly. You get ready to fly out of that cocoon. You get ready to fly. You're going to soar. You're going to soar in the things of the Lord. Come on, I need a real worshiper that will stand in the gap with her. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on, lift your voice and just say it. Let it rain. Say, let it rain.
Let it rain.
Open.
Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing, let it rain. Let it rain.
Say, open the floodgates. He's pouring it out right now, the rain.
Let it rain.
Let it rain.
Let it rain.
Open.
Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven.
Bring it down a little bit. Your hand, son. Come here. You're going to walk with me for a minute. Because the Lord gave me a decree concerning you. What I see is that you've been angry a lot. You've been angry a lot. And you've been angry so much to the point to where you've just been wanting to just fight and you've been wanting to throw your hands and wanting to defend yourself and wanting to show everybody that you're not a coward and that you don't stand down to nobody. And what I see is the world has been trying to pull you into that dark place. But God said he decided to pull you through. He says, I do not want you to go into that place, but I'm going to take you into a new place. I'm going to take you into a new place. This new place is a place of joy. This new place is a place of peace. This new place is a place of hope. This new place is a place where victory rises. God said, I'm going to give you victory over every attack that's come against you, that's come against your mind and your heart. He says, and I'm going to cause you not to be moved by the influences around you, not the folks around you. And I hear the Lord saying that you're going to do a lot better in school. You're going to do a lot better in school. School has been a challenge for you. It's been a serious hardship for you. And God said, I'm going to use you in the school grounds. He says, I'm going to put you, you're going to graduate and you're going to elevate. You're going to go to college and you're going to do some amazing stuff. You hear what I'm saying? You're going to do some amazing things. And all these folks around you trying to stop you, trying to pull you into that stuff. God said he's going to reverse everything that the devil meant for evil and cause some great things to be manifested in you. I speak that over you, the hand of God, the covering of God, the protection of God, the anointing of God that will lead you, that will guide you, that will direct you. Oh God, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And he says, I'm putting your enemies underneath you, enemies under your footstool, in the name of Jesus. And he says, he's going to cause you to walk in love and unity, even in your home. He says, I'm bringing restoration in the family.
He says, I see the war and the tug of war that's going on in the house. But he said, I'm bringing things back together in the love of God. Come on, I need a real praiser that will stand with this young man of God, this young soldier of God, this young fighter for Jesus. Fighter for Jesus. Thank you, God. Out of his soul, out of his heart, let the Spirit of the Lord reside and dwell. Move, God, as you have declared, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And there's a specific young man you hanging with that God said he gonna remove him. He got to get out of your life because he ain't good for you. That dude ain't good. Whoever that is, you know who it is. And God said, I'm going to pull you away from him because they're not good for you. He's not right for you. He said, I'm going to deliver you from him. See, that's your deliverance. Praise God with him in this room. Let it rain. Spirit of God, fall fresh. Let it rain in this fall place. Fresh. Fall fresh. The Lord said, you ready to start walking in your purpose now. You ready? You got so much to love and share and tell some of these young folks and tell your testimony about how the Lord has blessed you. And he said, and you shall declare it. And he says to also tell you that this prayer, he's stretching his hand out towards your mom. Oh God. He said, speak your mother over you. He said, because he said, I'm pulling through. I'm pulling through. I'm pulling through. He said, I'm going to pull her through. Pull her through. Pull her through. Come on, I need a praiser that will worship concerning this. Huh? He said, I'm stretching my hand to grab your mom and pull her through. You've been concerned about her. You've been concerned. Over the years, you've been concerned. Yeah. You've been concerned. Lord, you got to do something for my mom. Some of the things that she is going through, you've been thinking in your mind, Mom, you don't have to deal with that kind of stuff. Mom, you don't have to go through. In your spirit, you've been feeling like, Lord, I pray that she just understand. And God said he's going to do some reconciliation there too. Reconciliation. So God said, praise him, not only for what he's going to do in you, but thank him for what he's doing for your mom on your behalf. Everybody at the altar. I want you to say this prayer with me. I want everybody to say this together. Lord Jesus, thank you for your word. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your forgiveness. Thank you for your love. Bless my life. Save my life. Save my family. I am glad that I am saved. I am grateful to be saved. Thank you, Lord, for your glory in this place. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, Father, I stretch my hands over everyone in this room and in this house who've accepted you, who believes you, who trust you today. May your hand continue to bless them. May your hand continue to fill them. May your love consume them. We give you honor and glory in this place. Ministers of the altar, come forth. We're going to pray for those who are remaining at the altar. Come forth. If you're at the altar, you need prayer, stay here. If you're in the audience and need prayer, take the middle aisle. Before we leave the building, we want to pray for those who need prayer today. I'm not afraid. Oh, God of us. Oh, glory, glory, glory. I'm not afraid. Glory, glory, glory. Show me your glory, God.
Show me your glory.
Show me your glory. Show me your glory. And he says, this song is for you. He's showing you his glory. He said, I'm showing you my glory. Showing you, revealing my glory. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Come on, catchers. Come on, deacons. Let's serve.